We're given information in this problem on an adiabatic CSTR. And what we are shown here is a plot of the concentration of the product B for a reversible reaction as a function of temperature from just solving the mass balance. So if we pick a certain temperature, then we're going to get a certain concentration. We haven't yet solved the energy balance. And this plot shows that as we increase the temperature up to about 360 degrees Kelvin, the concentration of the product increases. And then as we go to higher temperatures, the concentration of product decreases because reversible reaction and it's exothermic reaction. So we're given information about the feed, density, heat capacity. We're given the heat reaction for this exothermic reaction. And the question is, what is the ratio of the reaction rate if we have a feed temperature of 315 Kelvin to the reaction rate if we have a feed temperature of 295 Kelvin? So what we're asked to do essentially is solve now the mass and energy balances simultaneously for two conditions, find the steady state solutions, look at the relative reaction rates at those two conditions. So this means we're going to write down the energy balance that we want to solve simultaneously with the mass balance. And we want to now plot this energy balance on the same plot. Energy balance, adiabatic, CSTR, steady state, really just has two terms. There's no accumulation. There's a term, density times volumetric flow rate is a mass flow rate, times a mass heat capacity, and a temperature difference. This is the energy, if you like, the heat up the feed to the reactor temperature. And then we have a term for the heat of reaction times the rate that we're making the product, the rate that we're using up reactant since its stoichiometry is 1:1. And that's the molar flow rate, which is the volumetric flow rate, the exit times the concentration of product as the exit. And because it's adiabatic, this Q term is zero. And notice this sign is negative, taking energy to heat up our feed to the reactor temperature. Because this is exothermic reaction, this term is positive, and so things are consistent. So we can take this energy balance and just write it in terms of concentration as a function of temperature. We're going to get a linear relation between the two. So I've taken the equation and note that I can cancel the volumetric flow rates from both sides. I've rearranged to solve for the concentration of B. Notice also I switched around T minus T zero and kept signs consistent. Now I've substituted in the values with the units to check that units are consistent, and I end up with the equation with just a linear relationship between the product concentration and the temperature. This is, of course, what we expect for an adiabatic reactor. So we can now plot this, and we want to plot it for two conditions. One, in which the feed temperature is 295 Kelvin. So T0 is 295, and then we want to plot it for T0 is 315 Kelvin. So using the slope in this equation, I've plotted, of course, these are parallel lines, the same slope. The only difference is the intercept. And then the steady state solutions are the points where the mass balances and the energy balances intersect. So we can then estimate the concentration here for this feed temperature of 295, and then we can estimate the concentration here for this feed temperature. Problem says determine the ratio of the reaction rate. So the rate for condition 2, which is 315, over the rate for condition 1, which is 295 feed. And this ratio then, the rate is equal to the rate that we're forming B. The second condition, second feed temperature, the rate that we're forming B in the first, which is volumetric flow rate times the concentration. And so we cancel the volumetric flow rates, and we just need to read the concentration. So approximately 0.0064 for the higher feed temperature, 0.0001 for the lower feed temperature. And notice these units are moles per centimeter cubed. And as we mentioned, the temperature's in Kelvin. So this ratio is 64. What this says is for a 20 degree increase in temperature, we get a dramatic increase in rate because our reactor temperature goes up. So the reactor temperature for the first case, very low reaction, it's close to 295 Kelvin, not exactly. And the reactor temperature is maybe 375 Kelvin. So we've jump from a lower steady state, low conversion steady state, to a high conversion steady state because it's nonlinear behavior of CSTRs and the feedback between the energy generated and the increase in the rate constant.